praise God, there's sometimes in learning God, we get to a crossroads. Do I have anybody that's ever in your life been in a crossroads? Y'all not gonna talk. Do I have anybody watching me on TV that's ever been at a crossroads? You're at a point of decision we call the crossroads. But what I like so much about the crossroads is that the cross is always in the middle. We're going to catch it tomorrow. The cross is always in the middle. So when you get to the crossroad, just make sure you look up at the cross. Oh, Jesus. Oh, because when you look up at the cross, at that point, it's your decision to decide what you see. Do you see somebody who's worthy? Or do you see somebody who's worthy of condemnation? Do you see somebody who's worthy of glory? Or do you see somebody who's worthy of fault? David proved that David looked at God because he proved that he was worthy. Now, how did he prove to David that he was worthy? He proved to David he was worthy because as a child and as a youth, David had health issues. Oh, yes, he did. He has identity issues. He had acceptance issues from his friends and his family. He had self-esteem issues, which could have destroyed his vision and could have destroyed his purpose. But let me tell you what God did. Even with all of David's issues, God showed himself as a healer. He showed himself as a protector, and he showed himself as a friend. What does that mean, Sister Sandra? That means he's worthy. I wish I had somebody to talk to me. Do you believe he's worthy this morning? I just want you to holler out. If you believe he's worthy, just tell somebody he's worthy. So even as a young man, how did he prove himself? How did God prove himself to David as a young man? Well, he proved himself to David as a young man because he could have been killed in the army. He could have been killed by his family. He could have been killed by his friends. But God proved himself as a protector. He proved himself as a provider. He proved himself as a promoter. He proved himself as a pruner. And he proved himself as a promise keeper. Because God made the promise to David 15 years before he became king. And I'm here to let you know that when God makes you a promise, it doesn't matter how long it takes. When God makes you a promise, it doesn't matter how bad it feels. When God makes you a promise, it doesn't matter who agrees with it. When God makes you a promise, it doesn't matter who likes it. When God makes you a promise, it doesn't matter who comes against it. When God makes you a promise, it doesn't matter who tries to tear it down. When God makes you a promise, he'll use those same enemies that try to destroy you. He'll use those same enemies that try to hurt you. He'll use those same enemies that try to tear you down to bring something great outside of you. Because when God makes a promise, I've got good news for you. Every word of God is yea and amen. In him, through Christ Jesus. Do you believe it today? Can you shout yes, Lord? Every word of God that he said, he will bring it to pass. I don't care what it is. I don't care how bad it looks. I don't care who said no. I don't care who turned you away. I don't care who cut you off. We serve a God who's able to do exactly what he said he would do. So what makes him worthy? I said, what makes him worthy? What makes him worthy is that he won't lie. He can't lie. He's never lied. He never told me that I wouldn't hurt. He never told me that I wouldn't suffer. He never told me that I wouldn't cry. He never told me that people wouldn't leave. He never told me that people wouldn't talk about it. But what he said is that when you cry, I'll wipe your tears. Woo! Lord, have mercy. What he said is that when you hurt, I'll heal the hurt. What he said is that when you suffer, I'll strengthen you while you suffer. What he said is if you're faithful, I'll bless you in the middle of your mess, so that everybody that tried to tell you that, they'll see it's not you. It's not you. It's not you. But it's all me. How I wish I would get this. That's working through me. Can you see? Yes, Lord. We found out that's what makes him. What makes him worthy as a middle-aged man and as an old man. David, he faced some hard times, some difficult times, some family matters. He faced some awful times. The death of his child, the death of another son, being incarcerated. I got a daughter who was violated by my son in a mental institution. I got a wife who died. I got one son trying to kill me, and my best friend killed my son. How in the world can I stay sane in all of this? What makes you worthy in all of that mess? What makes you worthy when my child's in jail, when my daughter's hurting, when my son is dead, when my wife is gone, when my kingdom wanna turn their back and kill me? What makes you worthy? Let me tell you this. Let me tell you this. What made him worthy is David. He sat around. He thought about it. He said, I lost my son, but God, you were able to strengthen me in the midst of my pain. That's why you're worthy. Because if it wasn't for you, I would have lost my mind. Hallelujah. What makes you worthy? You became, I saw Jesus become my captain. Yeah, Lord. I saw Jesus fight my battles. I wish I would talk about it. There's some battles that we try to fight them. But how many know? Can't nobody fight. I wish I would talk. Can't nobody fight for you like the Lord. Can't nobody fight for you like Jesus. Can't nobody fight for you like God. Because your arms, their arms, is too short to box with God. But the Lord Jesus, yeah, Lord. I'm trying to act right. He's able. I said he's able. He's able. I found out for my own self that God is. I said God is. God is. He's able. He's able. Is there anybody that can testify? He's able. He's able. He's able to strengthen you when you're hurting. I know you're hurting. Can I talk to you, John? Can I talk to you? I know that you're hurting. I know that you're broken. He let me feel it. But he's able to strengthen you. He's able to hold you up. He's able not to let you fall. He's able to bring. Lord, have mercy. Is there anybody? I said, is there anybody in looking at your own life, you can testify that God, he was your captain. He was your judge. He judged when everybody else told you you were no good and a nobody. God, he looked at you and said, I see something good. I see something wonderful. I see something great. They might not see it, but I see something.